Hi, everyone, and welcome to the last lecture on social perception. So the first thing we'll talk about is correspondent inferences. And correspondent inferences is, again, all about how do we make judgments about other people's behavior, like all the ones in this lecture will be about. And the theory of correspondent inferences says the first question we ask is, could the person have realistically chosen something else? So, for example, if somebody's in the military and they do something because of an order, you're going to say, well, they probably did it for an external reason, for a situational reason, not for an internal reason. Another thing that we'll ask is the behavior socially desirable? So shaking hands is a pretty socially desirable behavior, and it's not really noteworthy. It doesn't really tell you anything about somebody if they shake somebody's hand, because that's something that's kind of socially desirable. And in fact, if somebody doesn't shake another person's hand, that actually does tell you something. So again, this is another question that you can ask to kind of do a little bit of detective work, that we all do this, and we all do this little bit of detective work to try and decide, is this an internal attribution or an external attribution that I'm going to make for somebody's behavior? The last thing that we can do is we can say, well, what are the consequences? Does this person gain something good or bad from this? So here's SpongeBob SquarePants, who looks pretty unhappy to be doing all of these chores. And so we would say, well, there must be something. He's not getting any pleasure from this. So there must be something outside of him that's getting him to do these chores. And so we'd probably make an external attribution for his behavior and not an internal attribution. It's not something that he's doing because he wants to. It's something that he's doing because he feels he has to. Trait inference essentially is that people will automatically make dispositional attributions for others' behavior. So if I show you a picture of this guy, this is an actor who plays this really spoiled brat of a king on Game of Thrones. And if you think about this actor, you'll probably maybe think some negative things because the character is very, very negative. But now here's a picture of the same actor being super cute with a puppy. And the GIF that this page came from is a titled "The Most Important Video of King Joffrey Kissing a Puppy You Will Ever See." So you can see that even for people who know that this person is an actor and isn't really like the character he's playing, the fact that he's being so friendly with the puppy just blows their minds because they make dispositional attributions for the actor about things that the character does, even though we know that it's an actor and it's not really who that person is. But you often find that people who play bad guys will say that people in the streets tend to treat them like they're bad guy characters because people find it very hard to distinguish between the character and the actor. And that's all about spontaneous trait inference. And now we'll talk about the three-state model of attribution. And the three-state model of attribution essentially says the first thing we do is we decide what the behavior is. And then we make an internal attribution, and then after that we will adjust for some kind of external possibility. So this is kind of similar to anchoring and adjustment that we talked about in a previous chapter. You're anchoring on this internal attribution, and then you adjust. So here's how this works. You see this guy, you characterize the behavior, he's shouting. And then you make an internal attribution. He's shouting because he's a bad guy. And then you adjust for external possibilities and say, but maybe it's just his job. So the three-state model of attribution says this is how we characterize other people's behavior and understand them. First, we label the behavior. Then we make some kind of internal attribution about it. And then lastly, we'll adjust, knowing that everybody isn't purely internally motivated all the time.